Hello, and welcome to Lady Applejack Speaks VA, a VA channel here on YouTube that focuses on the Netflix series Stranger Things. Guys, it's Monday, and I don't know about you guys, but I had a really, really rough Monday, and I just needed to decompress a little bit, and I thought, what better way to do that than to record a video for you all? So here we are. I'm recording a video for you guys. For series 4, Closer, which is the first series here on the channel that is strictly 17 plus. So, yeah. Yay! Hi! this is the second episode of this series, and the series was inspired by a fellow subscriber by the name of Emily Mills. Emily has been such a blessing to me because, they will send me messages on Instagram, and they'll be like, I'm so sorry, but I got this idea and I wanted to pass it on to you. And I'm like, no, do not say you're sorry, because I love it. I love it. Pass these ideas to me because they are that good. So Emily is the one that inspired this particular series, and I'm so excited to give you guys a second episode. I'm glad that you guys enjoyed the first. I hope you enjoy the second. It's going to be a hot one. Well, mildly hot. Before I jump into the details of the episode, I just want to tell you guys, I am absolutely shocked by this. I was looking at the channel just a couple minutes ago, and do you guys realize that as of right now, this is going to be video 59 on the channel? I'm almost hitting 60 videos. Guys, that's fucking insane. I didn't think I was going to get past 6 videos, much less 60. Good Lord. I'm just in shock. I'm just in total, complete shock. So, yeah, I'm thinking eventually doing a live. Maybe I could do a live video for the 60th episode. I don't know. You guys tell me. If you want me to do a live, I'll do a live at some point. That way we can hang out. I have to give Lexi VA some more credit on this. Lexi VA does a lot of good lives. And I was talking to Lexi about thinking about doing a live, but not quite sure. And Lexi was just, you know, Lexi's just amazing. And was like, yeah, you should do a live. They're fun. And I'm like, okay, I'll think about it. So if that's something you guys want, let me know in the comments below, and I'll be happy to accommodate that. Maybe I could do that for the 60th episode premiere or something like that. Whatever. You know what I'm talking about. Anyways, this particular episode, let's talk about it. Now, first off, like I said, this is the second episode of the Series 4 Closer series. And this episode is taking place on September 13th at night on... Rewind, September 13th, 1985, which would have fell on a Friday that year. This is 8 p.m., and this is, if you guys remember from the first episode, this is shortly after Liz and Eddie have detention together, because Liz basically told Eddie to strip in the middle of the freaking cafeteria, and that's what he did. He stripped off his shirt and gave it to her, and then he ended up in detention. Of course, that was intentional on Liz's part, because she did not want to be in detention by herself. Our Liz is a little bit of a bad girl. Let me just say, Lis Vanguard is a little bit of a bad girl. So that's what we're focusing on here, is they're both, Eddie and Liz are equally bad in their own ways, but they're oh so good together. If you guys don't remember, Lis Vanguard and Eddie are really good, close friends. They were best friends growing up. They pretty much knew each other from toddler age onwards. And as time progressed, Eddie started gaining a little bit of feelings for Liz. And maybe the same could be said for Liz. I'm not quite sure. We'll just have to find out. But anyhow, this episode is going to be rated R for strong language and some suggestive sexual themes. So listener discretion is strongly advised. However, you guys know how I am. I am not Steve Harrington. I'm not about to go run up on anybody's doorstep. No, not my thing. Not doing it. But you have been warned. We'll just say that. You've been warned. The pepper rating on this is 2 ghost peppers of a quarter cup of milk still. So not too hot, but hot enough. Hot enough. It gets some intensity. And the song title that we're using for the title of this episode is More Than a Feeling. Have any of you guys heard that song? Let me tell you, it is one of my favorite songs. If I had to pick 10 songs to listen to on repeat and on a desert island for the rest of my life, this song would make the cut, hands down. Boston was the band that did this song, and it was like the late 70s, early 80s was when they were really big. And I can remember my first job when I was like in, I was like 15 or 16 years old. It's like my first job that I got with my first paycheck. I ran out to the CD store or the record store, whatever the hell you want to call it. It was CDs primarily. Then I ran out and bought this particular album with More Than a Feeling on it, because this was like the song for me. It was the song for me. I was in my first serious relationship at the time, and I was bound and determined to learn this song on guitar. I never managed to do it, but I was bound and determined. I think that should count for something. So if you've never heard this song, you need to go check it out. More Than a Feeling by Boston. After you check that out, check out the rest of their songs, because they were chef's kiss. Mwah! Amazing. Anyways, I'm done ranting about that. So who is going to be the narrative on this? Well, Eddie is. Yes, Eddie. Our beloved Eddie. He is the narrative in this whole entire script. And you can internalize it, you can fourth wall it. I will say for the record that when I write Eddie, I tend to think of him talking in a fourth wall perspective where he's like talking to a camera. So maybe you want to give that a shot. Not mandatory, obviously. But yeah, with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the episode, and I hope you enjoy it. Eddie's point of view at Enzo's before D&D. I'm in my van, waiting for Liz to finish her shift. After her stunt that got me detention, I made her feel so guilty that she agreed to sweet talk to the manager about letting her leave early today. Her manager, douchebag named Trent, is a 22-year-old college dropout that carries a huge hard-on for Liz. Anytime Liz wants to leave early or skip a shift, she normally gets away with it. I can't stand how the prick looks at her when she isn't watching. Checking out her legs, ass, and tits. It takes everything I have not to beat the shit out of the little creep on a daily basis. I even tried talking Liz into going somewhere else for a job. But the tips pay well, and she's got seniority, so. I look down at my watch, heaving a sigh before tapping along to Quiet Riot's Bang Your Head. Come on, Liz. Shit. Jesus, I have to be at D&D in 20 minutes. Oh, good. There she comes, wearing her normal Enzo's attire. The fitted white dress shirt, black vest, black silk tie, nude stockings, knee-length skirt, and those black stiletto heels. God damn, those black stiletto heels. Shit. I can't say when I started having feelings for Lisetta Vanguard. It just sort of happened. It was like an overnight thing. Me taking notice of her at Harrington's Halloween party last year. She was dressed like a Playboy bunny, but wearing her signature combat boots. The ones with the lacy laces. Those combat boots. Fuck. Every time she wears them, I can't help but look her over. Watching her cross her enticing legs. Watching her crush out her spent cigarettes with the toes of them. She has a habit of wearing those boots with her black short skirts. Making my mouth water. Fuck. Anyways, back to my story. She was dressed as a Playboy bunny, donning a classic black satin bodysuit, the lined stockings, that signature bow tie, cuffs, and the little bunny ears. Her ebony hair was curled and her makeup natural. A bit smoky, but overall natural. She looked drop-dead sexy that night, and she knew it. You could tell that she knew it. Flashback. October 27th, 1984. Harrington's house. I don't dress up for Halloween. It's not my thing, and besides, I had just left work. All I wanted was a few beers and some munchies. Harrington and Liz both insisted that I come to the party tonight. I could always say no to Harrington, no problem whatsoever. But Liz, Liz always wins every argument, much to my dismay. It's always been that way with Liz. Liz had been slowly savoring the peach schnapps that she had stolen from the liquor store prior to making it to Harrington's. A silver hip flask underneath the black lacy garter on her right hip. Soon, she was dancing around, dancing the night away, floating between partners with little to no interest. Soon, she was making her way towards me. I had reserved a spot in a nearby recliner. Working on my second beer. She grinned at me before straddling my lap, pulling her flask from its place underneath the garter. She unscrews the cap and brought it to my lips, her green eyes daring, taunting.
Ex, you seriously have to try this stuff. It is so yummy. It tastes like summer.
I take a sip to appease her, smiling afterwards. Yep, it tastes good. Whew. I can't believe you were able to lift that whole bottle. How the hell did you not get caught?
She brings the flask back up to her lips, taking another slow sip from it. Her long, graceful neck fully exposed, practically begging me to lick and suck at supple skin. Instead, I settle for resting my hands on her outer thighs, gripping them so she won't slide off my lap in her drunken stupor. I might have distracted the clerk a little bit with my with my costume, you know. They like cute, fluffy bunny butts, I guess. Ooh, gosh. You're wicked, Vanguard, and you're wicked drunk, too. But it worked. Are you ever going to get up and dance with me?
Sweetheart, you know I don't dance. She pouts, closing her hip flask and sliding it back underneath her garter. She then rests her small left hand on my torso, fisting my fitted black t-shirt in her hand. She bites her lip, and it takes everything I have not to get hard underneath her weight.
You're no fun, Edward Wayne Munson. Please, just one dance. Oh, listen, my favorite song is playing. Come on, can you please dance with me just for a little bit? I'll leave you alone, I promise.
Boston's more than a feeling. Looking back, it was very fitting for that very moment.
Shit.
Fine. One dance. Come on, bunny. Get up. She's elated and quickly slides off my lap, pulling me up. She wraps her arms around my neck and steps up onto my toes with my steel-toe boots. I wrap my arms around her waist and take the lead. Oh, Jesus, you're drunk, bunny.
And you're cute, Elmer Fudd.
What's Doris gonna say when you come home roaring drunk like this?
Nothing, because I'm not going home tonight.
You aren't. Where are you going then?
I'm going home with you, silly rabbit. I'd rather spend my hangover with you than alone. If that's okay.
Yeah, it's okay, bunny.
Bunny, I like that. Can you call me that from now on? Like a pet name?
Yeah, I can do that for you, bunny. In flashback. My memories fade as Liz gets inside the passenger seat of the van, wasting no time pulling off her heels and stockings.
I know. Trent was giving me a hard time about leaving early. Spare me the tongue lashing and drive while I get into something more game appropriate. God, my feet are killing me.
Trent was giving you a hard time? How so?
You know how he is. He was trying too hard to barter with me. The rest of the night off for a date with him this Saturday. Oh, God. Fucking creep. What did you say? Liz shrugged before pulling her skirt off to reveal some black lacy panties that, oh, fuck, displayed her perfect round ass. I swallow hard as I watch her pull her torn black Jordache jeans on. She then pulled off her vest, the tie, and the dress shirt, revealing her matching lace bra. Fuck. Dead puppies, Munson. Henderson's mom in a bikini swinging from a stripper's pole. She pulls my Hellfire shirt on, one that she took from me in the cafeteria today. It's large on her, so she ties it up in a little knot, showing her tan stomach. I have to admit, she looks good in my clothes. I told him to get bent. That's my girl. What can I say? You taught me well, Fudd. Hey, would it be okay if I crash with you tonight? Doris is having one of her dipshit gentleman callers over. And you know how that is. Yeah. Yeah, that's fine. Wayne's working tonight anyway. Maybe after the game we can watch some horror movies, pop some popcorn. Oh, I got an idea. Do you got any more of that stuff from last time? The Special K? As a matter of fact, I do. Why? Silly, but how about we get high and go stargaze in the field behind your lot? We haven't done that in so long. Yeah, we could do that, Bunny. Hey, I got a mixtape for you anyways, a brand new one. Maybe I could take my boombox out and we could listen to it together.
I'd like that.
She smiles at me before pulling on her combat boots. I feel an involuntary shiver go down my spine as I think about how sexy she would be wearing just those boots, calling all the shots. We make it to D&D on time. She jumps out of the van and grabs her backpack. I follow suit and lead her over to the door. Remember, Vanguard, no cannibalism.
Absolutely no cannibalism. That's so 83. Time to introduce the sheep to the bubonic plague.
Oh, Jesus, Bunny.
You know you love me.
All right, and that's the end of episode 2 for series 4, Closer. Let me know what you guys thought by leaving your comments below or hitting the thumbs up button. If you are new to the channel or you've been kind of lingering, kind of wondering if you should subscribe, why not? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and hit the little notification button right next to it, and you'll be hearing from us on a regular basis. And by us, I just mean me. It's just me. Maybe my cat as a guest star, but most of the time it's just me. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. I'm also kind of toying with the idea of doing a flashback episode just for the Halloween party, because a lot did happen at the Halloween party that kind of jump starts this whole thing. So if you guys want to see a flashback episode of the Halloween party, let me know and I'll be happy to provide it. But yeah, in the meantime, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. It was a lot of fun to write, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye. Bye.
Thank you.